you were already a mother when you married him, right?
Right, yep.
He accepted your child.
You slapped me.
I'm slapping the shit out of you. He accepted your child. You didn't give him a child. And you start cheating on him. Were you cheating on him with your baby daddy?
Yeah.
You trash biznatch.
Wow.
I meant that. That's trash, ma'am. That is some trashy shit. That is some trashy shit.
It was. It was very trashy. It was.
Holy crap. All right. Who ended up filing for divorce?
Me.
In your personal relationships with men, have they become easier?
Yes.
Have they become more productive?
Yes.
Where is the proof of that?
Proof of it is in my peace of mind. It's in the quality of men that I've dated. It's also within my mental health.
The proof would be if you had a man. That's the only way to prove that, ma'am.
Maybe it's time to stop because I don't know why you're cursing at me. I guess
yeah, get the fuck off my phone. Well, it all depends upon the intellectual dominion of the world and the transgressions and the aquameridians of the Bernoulli equations. And if you if was a fifth and you get down to do the butt, do you have a man? Nope. Are you having better personal relationships? Yes, I certainly am. Where's your man? Don't have one. How can you tell? Well, I feel better about not having one. Did I miss that somebody?
I'm not a lot of chubby dudes, so.
No, but okay. How much do you weigh?
220.
I weigh 210 and I'm 6'4". You broke the first rule. See, you ladies don't mind breaking the rules. The men are visual. The men want women that are fit, feminine, friendly, cooperative, submissive. And I don't mind being the size of, I'm sorry, you're 5'8"?
I'm 5'8".
You're about the size of Emmitt Smith or Barry Sanders was. You're running back size.
Okay.
You can hit the A-gap like a motherfucker.
Yeah, all right. I accept
so don't
that.
Come in here talk about what men should not be able to do when they got to accept somebody who can run out the power eye.
Okay.
I mean, right. I'm being silly.
But at the same time, no.
I'm being silly because, but I'm being silly because to make a point. Name me the product that gains value with age and use.
A product that gains value with age and use.
Yeah.
I want to say your mind, but I may be different. I may be
wrong. No, I said a product. Where can you go buy a mind? A product.
A product. I don't know, but I'm pretty sure you're going to tell me.
Yeah, nothing.
Wow.
Nothing. And let's just talk about your cookies. They're getting older and they've been used.
That don't mean nothing.
You're right. They don't.
Oh, you are honry. You are
no,
honry.
I'm honest. I'm honest, ma'am.
No, I'm just giving you my reality because everybody else out here acting, living this facade in this fairy tale world.
You need to connect your microphone. You need to connect your microphone. Lieutenant Worf, connect your oh, God. Michael Dorn in this bitch. Oh, come on. Connect your microphone, man. Connect your microphone. The clock. Security detail. Oh, God. Oh, shit. Go to hell.
You missed.
Oh, God. Lieutenant Dimmer. Oh, go ahead and unmute you. Okay, I'm going to. Hey, how are you? Hello? P'clock. Hello?
Yes, it's connected.
And where would you rank yourself on the open market?
I'd say about a 7, 8.
You can't use 7.
Why not?
I don't have to explain it to you. I said you can't use 7.
Why?
Young lady, I'm going to say it one more time.
So what number should I use?
The right one, which is a 5.
A 5?
Yeah. You're a bit of a 5.
Why would I be a 5?
Because you're average.
Okay, and what makes me average?
Because you look average. You go in the club, you stand in a long line. You don't get in VIP. You stand in line with the men. It's not a bad thing. You don't
ain't
ride
not
up.
Even a 6?
No, not even a 6.
Wow.
Why, man? What's wrong with being average, though? From 1 to 10, and you can't use 7. Face only, no hair extensions, your natural hair, your natural face. What would you give yourself?
Interesting. 8.
Nope.
No?
No. Beyonce is an 8. Kelly Rowland's a 9. You give yourself Beyonce looks?
Based off what men have told me, they have said I'm a 9. You probably, I
saw you pop up. I saw you pop up.
Yeah, I just came from the gym, so I look rough.
Beauty is beauty. I'm an image consultant. Okay. I'm not here to hurt feelings, but it's just not, no. Because the only reason you like women like that is because you're broke. Listen to what I'm saying before you get upset. Show me the woman a man would pick if he had $500 million in the bank. And I'll show you the woman he really wants. This whole thing about thick. Thick. Curvy. Voluptuous. No. You're heavy. We actually have women who can be, look you dead in the face at 25 years old and be a size 16 and think they are fine. We need to stop lying to women. If you're a man, I like a little meat on my, you need to stop lying. Because the only reason you like women like that is because you're broke.
If we have nothing positive to say, then in our experience, there's been nothing positive.
Well, if that's the case, you've picked them. Because just like every man you've chosen, there have been other men who may have been suitable, but he's not tall enough. He's not this, he's not that. Okay. There are no women on this panel that are hideous. You get to pick. See, what you cannot do is what women typically try to do. Absolve themselves from all accountability and consequence.
I believe that everybody gets consequences for what they choose to do. However,
really, I don't hear any on this panel.
So what about the women that didn't choose to raise a kid on their own?
Women are filing 70-80% of all divorces. Women are choosing to wreck their own homes every day. Men are not choosing to wreck their own homes and make women single parents. That's a choice that women are making.
Why? Because their husbands are trash, treating them badly?
Yeah, this is the same stuff that's been piped into the culture forever. That when a woman chooses to break her home, it's always the man's fault. You want children?
I'm 24 years old, so I haven't decided.
Well, 24 years old, have to do with anything.
I'm still young and living my life.
I swear to God, I did not pay her. She's been programmed to think my 20s are for me. So at late 20s and 30s, then I'll decide whether or not I want to have kids. And it's too late by that time.
I don't want kids right now.
Are you being actively vetted by a man of value to be his wife?
Yes.
Are you in a relationship right now?
No, I'm not.
Then you're not actively being vetted by a man of value to be his wife.
Okay.
Stop the cap. You go ask white women what to do. Or Hispanic women what to do, or Asian women what to do, because apparently they seem to know how to do something.
But they copying us. They copying black women. They get
where?
They get their nails done. They do get butt lifts, want bigger breasts, bigger lips.
Okay, let's run with that.
then if that's the case, why are they more married than y'all? Oh,
that's a good question.
Because they ain't copying y'all.
You don't think so?
Not the, they may be copying a look, but the software is different.
You know, it's okay for you to like give statistics, but if you can't give me the references and you can't show me,
go to, okay, well, I'm not going. Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, ma'am, ma'am. Don't play with me. Don't play. No. See, I'm about to go there with you because you asked me where I got them from, and all you got to do is get off your ass and go look for them yourself. But getting off your ass may be a big problem. See, when you play with me, I play back. Responsible for all the divorces, and he is not.
But God created marriage.
No, he did not.
Yes, he.
No, he didn't. Okay, you're going to argue. Okay,
I'm not going to argue.
You're 24. You're not going to argue with me because one, I know what I'm talking about, and I can. First of all, even if you're a Christian, you shouldn't be arguing with me in the first place.
Okay, correct.
Were Adam and Eve married?
Yes.
Who performed the ceremony?
Jesus did.
Oh, God? Shit. Seriously? I'm saying oh shit because are you serious? God, Adam and Eve were married? There was only one person on the planet. It was Adam. God put him to sleep and he went inside of him, took out a rib and said, flesh of my flesh. He made Eve. He presented Eve to Adam. They didn't get married. Who did the ceremony? Simba? Are you kidding? They weren't married.
The thing is that what works for a couple works for a couple. I can't.
Shut the fuck up, Lonnie, love. I've been wanting to say that for a minute. Shut up. I and men like myself absolutely don't care what your swole up ass has to say about anything. But yet you still find a way to get your big swole ass up here and still have an attitude problem about something. Seek help and shut up. Money putting food in your child's mouth because it ain't his. He didn't even get... Shut up. He didn't even get a child out of the deal. He's paying for another man's child who you called a loser. And then you have the nerve to come over here talking about I divorced him because he wasn't ambitious.
But
and
Kevin,
then you're
going to
get out here on the open dating market and tell this story. You are a permanent side chick, ma'am. You're a side chick because of your character. I don't need to hear any. I don't need to hear any. I don't need to hear the rest of the story. I don't need to hear how cute you think you are or how special you think you are. I don't want to hear any of this bullshit. Okay, I know this is fair. Are you married?
No, I'm not.
You ever been married?
No, I haven't.
Got any children?
No, I don't.
You got a girlfriend?
No.
I got several. I've been married, got kids. I think I know women better than you. You want to start pulling rank. I'm trying to be nice, man. Don't tell me about women if you ain't had no success with them, even fail with them.
I got you, brother. I won't even argue with you on that.
You can't argue this shit. I tried to let you off, man, but you're still pushing this point.
I'm 5'3".
How much do you weigh?
That's none of your business. I told you I was fat.
Oh, okay. We don't play that shit on my channel. You get your big fat ass on somewhere then. I don't deal with you big sassy ass broads.
Bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
If you think you can get out here and be like Danny's big ass, go knock yourself out. But I would be remiss to try to tell you as an image consultant and as a person and a professional that you can be 5'3 and weigh so much that you don't even want to tell somebody how much you weigh and think you're going to get a man to marry you, a high value man. So you go ahead and go on back over and get your 2-piece or 3-piece or whatever you got coming from, you know, Chick-fil-A or Popeyes or carry your ass on over. I've been on the Zoom call. When someone pops up, their photo is there. And people can switch their photos and things like that. But I also use another software
to where photo comes up and they're in a green room. Their photo, like what I'm looking at, is kind of grayed out. If you click the wrong button, something can come up. That person's photo can be there. That person's picture can be there. That was a person that was in a call queue. Was that the actual person who had fallen asleep? I don't know. Was that a photo that that person put up? I don't know. But I talked about this thing in show, real time. That person had gone from trolling me on one platform to where a woman was leaving like, who is that person? I was like, don't worry about him. He calls all the time. The destruction of the black male image because you're saying something that they don't like. We're going to minimize you. We're going to disparage you. We're going to discredit you. We're going to try to humiliate you. People really thought I was gay. They wouldn't be coming at me like this.
God in a marriage?
No, I just want to be clear. So when I start going in on Christian marriage, you don't start going sideways on me.
I don't know. I just feel like...
That's the point, sweetheart. You don't know. Eve's job was to be a helpmeet to Adam. That's your job. Your role on the planet is a man. Not your career. Not your job.
It's a man.
Take it up with your God. You don't like it.
Don't want a loyal woman. They want the
first of all, understand something.
Over here,
we stay on the subject. The men you decide to let in your bed are your problems.
That's what's so crazy.
Then where's your husband?
I'm picky. I have a problem. Like, I get good men, but I'm very picky. Like, I'm picky.
And you can't make this shit up.
You can do one thing, not be ready.
Hello. Hola.
Oh, this is going to be fun. They look good. Frames, fragrance, and footwear. Always take care. What are you guys doing after this?
Our drinks.
They're looking for fun.
Drinks.
I'll be talking to you guys later.
Father is doing better than most, but he's not making anywhere close to the exorbitant amount of money you just said. Mm-hmm. Why do you need that?
No, I thought you were asking the question.
Yeah, but you, I mean, I know how much money he would need to make, but what I'm saying, mm-hmm. I accept that. Mm-hmm. But it's close to $300,000, $400,000, but that's still a lot of money. Mm-hmm. Because the next questions come is, how tall are you?
Mm-hmm.
How tall are you?
So,
how tall are you? 5'3"? 5'4". Dress size?
8.
How much did you weigh last time you weighed yourself?
170-ish.
You're not a dress size. 8?
Yeah.
Okay. Image consultant in real life. If you're 5'4", 170-something, I can look in your face and tell you're closer to a 10-12.
No.
Okay. Hi.
Hi. I don't know what your topic is tonight, but I just.
How old are you? How old are you?
Guess.
Don't play with me. Guess these nuts.
I don't want to hear shit from you talking about you being broke. If you're not working 60 hours minimum a week that you're getting paid for, turn off YouTube, Instagram, whatever, and get your ass out there. Go down there and work at McDonald's, Circle K, get you a job. I don't care about your pride. You can't be proud and broke at the same time. Go work, work and work and work, and then you take that money you make from your part-time job, invest some of it, invest most and take half of it, invest it to your future. The other 50%, the other percentage, take some, have some fun, go buy your belt, then invest it in self-improvement. Get you a high income skill, get you something that's going to give you high value skills that you can market on, that you can leverage on the marketplace, whether you're working in corporate America or whether you're going to be doing your own entrepreneurial thing in the future. But men, if you're working, the harder you work, the luckier you get, the more exposure you get.
and your husband, so you what? Let's walk through this. You married, and then your husband wouldn't get full access to his new wife because first year law is 100 hours a week of work of reading. Mm-hmm. It's the weed out year. So he already wouldn't have a wife because if you never know anybody that went to law school, they're reading from sun up to sundown. It's the weed out year. Then you got to pass. So you got to do that. Then you got to pass the bar. So at what point does this man get his wife? Oh no, he gets a person in law school. All right, so he's basically sexless because it ain't like you're gonna be a fully functioning woman attending to his needs. You're gonna be so busy doing what you need to do. Then after you're out of law school, you're ready to pass the bar. You're pregnant. All right, then you got to try to join a firm and become a junior attorney. So you're dropping your kids off because you got to put in long hours. So from 7 to 7 or from 6 to 6, your kids are somewhere else. And your husband's doing what he's doing. You come home, you still got legal stuff to do. Who's raising your children? This is crazy as Nick Cannon, just because he has money making all these kids. You don't want to be a wife. You want a picture, a Norman Rockwell, maybe not a Norman Rockwell, you want a picture of something. But y'all think about the logistics of this. A bachelor's, a master's, now you want a law degree. This is ego. And that's supposed to make you a hell of a woman somehow? That's what's been marketed to our community. I said it before, in Black America, Black women in particular, when shit's going awry or upside down, they know what to do, they go back to school. But I'm going to ask you the first question. Where would your husband get a wife in this?
Honestly, I was just hoping he would be supportive. I mean.
Oh, thank you. So you'd be the husband.
I don't like that.
Can't make this shit up, people. Be supportive. To what end? And let's be clear, you want to be a civil rights attorney to help Black people, right?
Yeah.
But the very Black people, your Black husband and your Black children would be getting subpar.
When you walk by people, do guys stop and say, damn, she's fine?
Yes, sir.
Where? Put a picture of Beyonce and yourself up next to each other and you say, yeah, Jay-Z, I could be Miss Jay-Z.
As far as the face go, yes.
As far as the face?
Mm-hmm. She got me beat in the body department.
She has you, okay. Are you being serious?
Yes, sir, I am.
Well, no, that's not realistic, ma'am. So, that means you're on the level of a woman who would almost be expected to be able to find a man where she could be a stay-at-home wife and she would never have to work and she could just have children.
Yeah.
No. No. Let me just go ahead and say, your look, ma'am, you'd be fortunate to find a husband.
You ranked yourself. Honestly, if you ranked yourself on a scale of 1 to 10, what would you rank? Yeah, let's get back to reality.
No, I'm in reality.
No, you're not in reality.
You're not in reality.
You're not in reality. If you're going to be a 10, we can end this. Because that's not reality. You're not a supermodel.
So what are you based on?
You're not, okay, ma'am. Check the attitude. Let me just go ahead and say this. This bullshit that's running around with Black women, they call yourself a 10, never say you don't. That is some of the most destructive psychobabble is going on.
What's weight myself? I'm a 135.
You a 130?
Oh. You better go look on my Instagram, sir.
No, I'm looking at your fingers.
It doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm. How tall are you?
I didn't hear you.
How tall are you?
About 5'4".
5'4". Dress size?
Dress size, size 10.
How much did you weigh the last time you weighed yourself?
180. But as you can tell, I'm...
You're almost years old, and I am struggling to hold a simple conversation. Did you graduate from high school? What is the highest grade you completed? Okay. So what are you doing to get your GED? What are you doing to get your GED?
I didn't, but I'm for damn sure smart enough to get it.
We would like to get married, but he wants to make sure the investment's good, so he wants to have a kid first and then get married.
You're setting yourself up for disaster.
Men have no place at all to say how women should and shouldn't.
We have every place. We built the goddamn world you live in.
Oh. All right. See what I mean, bro?
What's up, world? What's up, America? There's a delay. Can you see that? There's like a delay.
Don't you come in here doing that shit.
What'd I do?
Acting a goddamn fool.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me fix my camera.
Let you fix your attitude. How you gonna come in here talking like that?
I was happy. I'm happy that you had me on. Look.
That does no, 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 no. That's in. How old are you?
Kevin, you act like you've never been.
How old are you?
I'll be 40 in November.
All right. Ma'am, this show is seen by hundreds of thousands of people.
Right.
You're representing the image of black women when you come in here.
Absolutely.
And you're 40? What do you want? What do you need?
Well, I'm looking for a good man to be a husband to me and to be a father to my children and someone who can support.
And what is he? And what is he gonna do? What is he gonna get from that? What is he going to get from you?
A beautiful wife.
That's a, that. Hold on. Beautiful wife. How tall are you?
5'4".
Dress size.
6.
That's your picture.
That is my picture.
How recent is it?
That's a 10-year-old picture. But I still look like that.
Beautiful women don't have 10-year-old pictures, ma'am. All right, we'll go ahead and put you on hold until you can get yourself together. I swear to God, if some.
I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. Women have no problem telling me they don't want. Matter of fact, they can become rich saying it.
At all.
And if I just happen to say, ma'am, and I was wrong, she actually weighed more than Emmett Smith, the Barry Sanders.
Run! Pay the child support. Run! Run, bro. Run! Run!
Run, bitch! Run!
Run! You do not need a sassy 300-pound woman with a GED thinking she got the keys to life. Run!
Really? But you don't even know me. You don't even know me.
What I do know about you is enough. Run! Run! Your man, what I do know is your man left.